testing some of the fastest internet speeds available on a plane.
This guy, Rich DeMuro, explains in today's Tech Smart. I think anyone who's flown on a plane and opts to buy the internet package or Wi-Fi, you can text your friends while you're on your spouse, whatever, while you're on a plane, but that's about all you can
do. That's about it. In fact, before this last flight, the last time I took a flight, I paid the $8 for the internet. Could not even check my email. It was that bad. Yeah. So I gave up. I just closed my computer, sent that email to the boss. I said, sorry, can't do it. That's why I was very excited to try this out. Hawaiian Airlines, one of the first to offer super fast Starlink internet on their flights. Recently, I took a flight from Long Beach to Honolulu to try it out.
I've been on plenty of flights before, but never one like this.
I've never had fast internet on a plane. I'm excited.
Hawaiian Airlines, among the first to equip their planes with Starlink internet, a network of low orbit satellites providing fast connectivity around the globe. Upgraded planes are marked with a Starlink sticker at the entrance. Hawaiian brought me on board to try it out.
So first things first, as a nerd, I've got to test the speed. 250, you'd be lucky if you had that at home. And we are halfway across the Pacific between LA and Honolulu.
I tried uploading and downloading large files, playing games, streaming movies, and even a Peloton workout on demand.
We're already streaming, so if you forgot to download a movie, there's no need to download anymore. You can just watch whatever you want on demand.
It all worked flawlessly with speeds well over 100 megabits per second.
It is really important for us as a smaller airline to have that distinctive level of service.
Hawaiian Airlines CEO Peter Ingram.
If you think about the real earliest generations of connectivity on airplanes, the common theme was it was terrible.
This connection is seamless and starts the second you get to your seat.
It comes from outer space.
I figured that, and I'm like, with this fast, it's working, this is amazing.
Feedback's been great, both from guests and flight attendants, right? They really are impressed by the quality of the internet signal.
This internet is so fast, you really don't have to plan ahead. So I see a world where those in-flight entertainment systems are probably going by the wayside.
Starlink is free, and Hawaiian plans to keep it that way.
We figured, since we were later to the party of providing internet connectivity on our airplanes, that we would just jump to offering the very, very best and offering it complimentary and letting the rest of the market try and catch up to us.
Well, it worked very well. Hawaiian continues to outfit their planes, so not every flight has Starlink just yet. And while there are no data limits and you can connect multiple devices, they do ask that passengers don't make voice or video calls, live stream from their seats, and of course, offensive content is not allowed. If you want to learn more about the Starlink on board Hawaiian, check out the website, richontech.tv. Incredibly game-changing.
Yes.
It literally just makes up in the air the same as being at home.
Yes.
And when you can stream Netflix and whatever whatever show you're binge watching, just continue without downloading.
That's what everyone has to do right now. They have to download their phone. And I believe I know Netflix for a fact puts a limit on how much you can download. So if you have a family.
Yes.
And this
person. I'm thinking about the kids.
Yeah.
We run into this all the time when we travel. Yeah. We're like, hey, because a lot of people are using the different devices.
Right.
Make sure you delete your downloads that you're not using.
All of that. Yeah. Will other airlines, do you think, follow suit?
Some of the other airlines in the world are doing this, like Zip Air that goes to Japan, like Baltic Airways or something like that. But none of the major carriers in the U.S. have announced this just yet. So we'll see. Mm-hmm. Like a Delta, United, American.
Good for Hawaiian.
Yeah.
It's fantastic.
It's a good differentiator.
Story. Thanks, Rich.
I see it. Trip to Japan.
Yeah, we made
and the Baltic.
It's funny. Yeah. During his lead, you were like, because he was like, I took it. It wasn't like Long Beach to San Francisco. It was Long Beach to Hawaii.
To check out the internet.
I will say, when I posted about Long Beach on my Instagram, people were going nuts. They're like, Rich, please do not give away our secret.
Yeah.
We love Long Beach Airport.
Yeah.
It was a great little airport. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's really good.
Secret's out.
What's that?
Secret's out.
Which island did you fly to?
I believe it's called Oahu.
Yes, Oahu.
Because you said Honolulu, right? Yeah. So Oahu, yeah.
I'm getting my Hawaiian down. Yeah. We have some more Hawaiian stories coming up. I didn't just do one thing while I was
there. Oh, okay.
You multitask.
Yeah.
Good for you.